My dear students and learners, today I shall discuss research methods for collecting primary data. Dear students, that for collecting primary data, there are three types of research methods. The research methods are the survey research method, observation research method, and experimental research method. So, today in this lecture, I will cover these three types of research methods for collecting primary data. Survey research is a research method for collecting primary data. Now, what is survey? Survey is conducted among the sample respondents. Dear students, you know that there is a difference between sample and the population, and also survey and census. Population is the whole group of the people with whom we are going to conduct the study. And sample is a part of the whole population. For example, if we are interested to conduct research among the garment workers of Bangladesh, and in Bangladesh there are more than 40 lakh garment workers. So here, in this case, the population will be 40 lakh garment workers. And when sample will be selected from this 40 lakh garment workers, maybe it will be selected on the basis of by using the formula and sampling method, maybe it is 399. Then and this 399 who represent 40 lakh garment workers of Bangladesh can be called as the sample. Now when sample is interviewed, sample respondents are interviewed, then it is called survey. And when population is interviewed and data collected from the population from each and every person, then it is called census. So survey research means the surveying the respondents who are the part of the whole population. Now in surveying method, usually this sample number of samples and the respondents included in the sample are selected in such a way so that they are representative of the population. Survey research is conducted with the help of a questionnaire or checklist. And questionnaire may be of two types, a structured questionnaire or unstructured questionnaire. Now with the help of this questionnaire or checklist, when the researcher conduct the survey among the sample respondents, then it is called survey research. Nowadays, survey not only can be done by personal interview, but it also can be done by using Google survey, by using technologies, email and other technologies, we can conduct the survey. Dear students, now we shall see an example of survey research. Here is an example of website user survey, and five questions are asked here. Question number one, the website has a user-friendly interface. Strongly agree, neutral, disagree, and strongly disagree. Similarly, question number two, the website is easy to navigate. The number three, the website's pages generally have good images. Number four, the website allows users to upload pictures easily. And number five, the website has a pleasing color schemes. Now, sample respondent will answer one from this scale, 5-point scale, strongly agree to strongly disagree scale. The second research method for collecting primary data is observation research. This is also a primary research. In this research method, experienced researcher observes the behavior of the people or the behavior of the objects and also the events, and based on it the researcher collects information, records the information, then describes and then analyze the information regarding the behavior of the people or the object. Observation research method is a research method, which is also called non-experimental research method. The main purpose of this research method is to describe the variables or set of variables. It is in fact a systematic observation, recording, then describing and analyzing the behavior of the people or the object. Dear students, now we shall see an example of observation research method. The situation is people watching people, then observers stationed in supermarkets watch consumers check out their groceries. The purpose is to see how much prepared versus fresh food is purchased by the consumers. The third type of research method for collecting primary data is experimental research method. This is a research method by which the information is collected systematically and experiment is conducted. This method is also called explanatory research method. It is not just exploratory or descriptive research method. In this research, cause and effect relationship is identified. Experimental research is applicable in social research when determining a causal relationship among the variables. You must select the experimental group where you can apply treatment and the control group. The effects of the treatment on the experimental group can then be compared to the control group. Experimental research answers the question, what if? The researcher manipulates independent variables and measures dependent variables in order to establish cause and effect relationships between them. The independent variable is controlled or set by the researcher. The dependent variable is measured by the researcher. An experiment is a prescribed set of conditions which permit measurement of the effects of a particular treatment. Dear students, now we shall see an example of experimental research method. Suppose you want to know whether commercials make people enjoy TV shows less. That means you will want to have some shows without commercials and some shows with them. Therefore, commercials or not is the dependent variable. And you will want to measure enjoyment of the TV shows they watch. Therefore, enjoyment is the dependent variable. So, in conclusion, in this lecture, we can say that for collecting primary data, we can use three types of research methods, such as survey research method, observation research method, and experimental research method. Dear students, I hope that this lecture will be helpful for you to understand the different types of research methods which are used for collecting primary data. Thank you.